Okay, you guys, we are on a Monday today and I'm all dressed up to go to work. But I'm going to take you on a flashback of yesterday, what I did to pamper myself. I gave myself a hair mask treatment and I did my eyebrows along with painting my nails. I had to show off my nails because I paint my nails at home. I hope I'm not overdoing it, but that is what I do. I don't know if you can see my hairdo. The natural sunlight is only focusing on my face, but... Hi guys, welcome to a new video. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell. I have been trying to be as frequent and as dedicated to this channel into uploading my videos. So, you know, a sub to the channel would be much appreciated. Your support would be duly considered, because I started this channel with the whole idea that I am able to speak as expressively and as fluently as possible. I don't know if I'm making sense, because I'm not good at public speaking. I'm not good at speaking in front of the camera, and this has been a very good exercise for me. So without wasting any time, let's get into the video. Okay, so today's video, if you have not seen my earlier video where I cut my hair this short just to match up with the avatar of my DP. And you know, once you cut your hair, that's the time where you start taking care of your hair. And I have like super dry hair. If you don't know what curly hair type is, it is like super dry and you need to treat your hair with a hair mask. So that is what I'm going to do. I have never done a hair mask. I used to only oil my hairs every weekend. Every weekend is like a oiling mask day, and that is all I did. I had never invested in masks like this, tub masks. This is something very popular. I have seen a lot of Indian YouTubers talk about this hair mask. It's the Aite, I don't really know how to pronounce that. That is the brand. It says healthy roots hair mask with the power of ginger and onion. Two times the power of ginger and onion. And the smell, this is the consistency of it. So this is something that I'm going to apply on my hair. The hint of ginger and onion is there in this hair mask, and I think it is going to be really promising. And the directions to this is, you're supposed to apply it on all the strands of your hair, leave it for 20 minutes, by applying steam towel. That is what you're supposed to do. Apply a hot towel to give that steam benefit for your hair. So it's going to give you super soft and clean head. Those are the claims of this hair mask. The ingredients also are quite good, like onion oil, ginger extract, curry leaf extract, radish root extract, brahmi shikakai, hibiscus, amla, jatamansi, vitamin E, almond oil, jojoba oil, argan oil, shea butter, cocoa butter, aqua, stearic acid, and glee. So, I don't know if you can see my hair. My hair is like super dry, and I'm going to coat my hair with this hair mask. I don't know if I'm doing it right. I've never used a hair mask as such, but I know my type of hair requires hair mask more than any other hair. Every weekend, this is what I'm supposed to be doing to my hair. My hairs have become so flaky, and I was using like a sulfate-free, silicone-free shampoo. I saw that my hair became even more flaky, and there was a lot of dandruff when I started, you know, going through that road of chemical-free as in sulfate-free, silicone-free. But my hair requires a little bit of silicone. I started using recently the herbal essence line of shampoo and conditioner, and it's really good. The Moroccan argan oil shampoo and conditioner. I'm just going to give this benefit to my scalp. This is supposed to help with hair regrowth also. So once I'm done, I'm just going to prepare my hot towel so that, you know, the steam can help with the extra hydration to be penetrated in my hair shaft. So I'll just go back, get the hot towel. So this I'm leaving up for 20 minutes, and once I'm done, I'll have a bath. I have my bath timing is anytime soon, so this will go on for 20 minutes or until my bath time is up. I don't mind exceeding the time with this because all the ingredients are super natural, and I have heard many YouTubers rave about this product. That's why I thought of trying it out. Once I'm done washing my hair, I would know the actual result or the actual outcome on my hairs, whether my hair feels hydrated and moisturized or not. Actually, the whole idea, it's supposed to feel hydrated. Now the next thing I'm going to do, since this is left to sit for that time, I'm going to do my eyebrows. I do my eyebrows at home, like extra hairs are peeking out. I'm going to use wheat gold wax strips. Everybody knows the infamous wheat gold wax strips. That is what I use to, you know, wax my hair. That is what I use to wax my eyebrows, not my hair. So what I do is I cut a whole wax strip in half like this, and then I'm going to cut into fine strips. Like so, and this I'm going to divide in two parts. So the wax, I just cut these wax strips in two pieces, and one just fell off. I had to go and find where exactly it fell off. I couldn't even find it. It just embellished in the floor and attracted some dirt. But anyway, we are going to prep my skin by applying some baby powder. The whole idea of applying baby powder is, you know, all your excess oil, your skin produces sebum, which is a natural skin oil. Natural oil that is excreted from your skin. I don't know if I'm speaking it right, but sebum. So sebum is the natural oil. Once I'm done applying the powder, I hope I didn't make a mess. I look really funny. We are going to get started with the waxing of my eyebrow. Okay, so we are first going to start off by removing excess hair that is on top, both sides. So for that, I'm going to take this spoolie. This is my Etude House eyebrow pencil. Spoolie on the end. So we brush all the hairs downwards like this. Even this side, I'm going to do the same thing. And we are just going to wax my eyebrows. I don't know if you can see the hairs. They're like little hairs. Okay, so now we are done with the upper portion of my eyebrows. We are going to brush my eyebrows upwards. going to just brush my hairs upwards and I'm going to cut it whatever length is there that makes it look all wild and bushy. Although this is like a trend now, I don't know. I think I'm done with my eyebrows. This I have to keep now for 20 minutes. I don't think 20 minutes are up. This was done in no time, 5 minutes. And I will be doing my nails also today. That also I'm going to put in this vlog. This is not like a professional video. I'm not a beautician or, you know, a professional salon lady. I just do my, I take care of myself at home. So this, I want to see the outcome of this. I will be doing my nails. I am confused in between a clear nail paint and a red nail paint. Although my whole inclination is towards the red nail paint, it will add up to the festivity. It's Christmas season, so I might go with the red nail paint. Just keep on watching till the end.
A few moments later.
Okay, so I just had a bath. The hair mask was kept for 20 minutes. I completed the time. And after my bath, I just let my hair air dry. I did as per usual. Shampoo, conditioner, I used the Herbal Essence, Moroccan Argan Oil, shampoo and conditioner. And this is what my hair looks like. I wouldn't say that, you know, like your commercial ads where I feel like a huge difference in my hair feels super soft and whatnot. But after applying the conditioner, let me tell you honestly, it does feel soft. It doesn't feel super soft, but it does feel soft and I see a slight shine. I don't know if the camera is doing justice, but it has literally my hair feels clean. It feels clean in a very healthy way. It's not like squeaky clean where everything is stripped out and the dry feeling. It just feels hydrated. That is what I feel with the hair mask. Now I'm going to paint my nails. I haven't applied also any product on my hair, by the way. No product is applied. It's just the I can't pronounce the name. The ginger onion hair mask that I applied. After that, directly shampoo and conditioner. No product was applied. This is what the curls look like. And now I'm going to paint my nails. I'm going to paint it red just because the month is all festive, Christmas season, so you can watch me paint my nails. I have this bright red shade which I want to apply on my nails. I have my nails cut in square shape. I will be soaking it slightly in water, in hot water, in, you know, Epsom salt, baking soda, just to get everything cleaned and prepped before I paint my nails. I'm not gonna put that clip in here, but that is what I'm going to do and apply this nail paint. Thanks for watching this video, you guys. If you like this video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Until then, bye.